What's up, fellas? Let me fix that. There we go. How's everybody doing tonight? Nice to see you guys. Oh, Peepo Hey worked. And Pepe Jam. Oh, they're all working. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Nice to see everybody. OBS, why are you saying that I'm streaming a dog shit? Bitrates? Is the stream already dead? I've been on for 10 seconds and it's already down? Classic. Seems like rental talk. Is that like a rent cuck? Is that like a wage cuck, but a rent cuck? Rentold. Imagine shaming people for renting property. Sorry I didn't just up and buy a fucking house. And if I did, it wouldn't be this shithole. The blades on my fan. Oh shit, I can't spin them right now because my green screen chains are hanging from the ceiling. The blades on my fan aren't even... It's four of them, right? They're not even at 90 degree, like, four-way symmetry. It's like... My fan looks like a fucking contorted swastika butterfly thing. Cat Jam best emote? Never heard of it, but I'll write it down, or maybe we'll just peep. I think I have one FFC slot left. Maybe. Let me make sure my door's shut. Oh my god, how are y'all doing tonight? Man, I got some shit. I need a vent. How much for that painting of Yeet? Dude, I made that myself. Only one of these puppies in the world right here. Oops. One of my housemates lives on the other side of that wall, and these walls are paper thin. Oops! Sorry, brother. How much for that painting? 50 gifties. 50 gifties? Easy. Yeet painting's yours. Only one like it in the world. Painted by yours truly, Master Artiste. There's only one artist in the world that eclipses me. And his name is Picasso. And you can hire him. You can contract him to paint a painting for you. And he's skilled. He'll paint a beautiful thing. And then you can get it shipped to a friend as a gift or something. And it's a perfectly, perfectly gorgeous painting until you realize that the only painting implement he uses is not a paintbrush. Nay, that's so 2000 late. No, our friend Picasso here paints exclusively using his cock. Now that's talent. What's up, Poyos? Oh, I'm loving all the Peepo Haze. I like having that be the going live notification, have people respond with an emote. I think that is the move. Shout out to Maya for that idea. The actual goat. FTL, anybody? Any faster than lighters? Spaceman! My man! Oh, what's up? Cool cock story. Hey, nice cock, bro. Oh, it's nice to see you all out here tonight. Boy, I have had a fucking day. No, yesterday. Yesterday was a real fucking day. What happened? I lost my earbud. You know the little jelly? Okay, so I've got these shitty, like, knockoff Chinese wireless earbuds, right? They're basically AirPods, and I just noticed the Poyos made me do push-ups. Fucking, wow, starting off big and strong. All right, I see you. So this is not a real company. This is some dog shit name that someone in China thought would make a good company name. Just like the really sketchy Asian food restaurant down the street from me called Yummy Time. Okay, look me in the eyes. If I was gonna start a restaurant to be a front for my drug business, I would call it Yummy Time. Tell me that shit's not shady. Everybody else around me is like, yo, dude, the food's good. It's nice. Stop shit-talking it. Yeah, but you know they can afford good ingredients because they're dealing fucking crack, bro. What was I talking about? I don't even remember what I was talking about. Oh, my earbuds. So I'm walking down the street. My earbuds are pretty shitty, and those little, The little gum balls that stick on the end, this little shit, right? This dingus, it's kind of loose, right? It comes off relatively easy. Never would I expect. Oh god, there was one event 2 years ago when I was no, maybe 1 year ago. I haven't had these that long. Last year, I was using these and I took one out of my ear. It's like 2 in the morning, right? I was having trouble falling asleep, so I got out of bed and went into the living room just to watch some YouTube or Twitch or something, shoot the shit. And I take the earbud out of my ear because I'm ready to go back to bed. I'm like finally relaxed. I pull it out of my ear. Here's what comes out. This shit is now fucking lodged into my ear. I just clipped my fingernails, so there's not a fucking chance I'm getting enough traction to pull it out. But 2 a.m. groggy Ben is still like, oh yeah, grip it and rip it, brother. I can get that out of there. So I go fishing for it with my fingers. Dipshit. Stupid. I just push it deeper in. And now it's part of my brain. It's become one with my mind. I had to sulk into my room shamefully, accidentally wake up my roommate and wake up my girlfriend, and have her use two mechanical pencils with a very fine point, like this kind of thing, two of these, and a phone flashlight, and just dig into there and extract it surgically. It was so fucking scary. I thought this ear was just gonna have a little tube in it for the rest of my life. Oh my god. Of course, now I wasn't able to sleep at all because I was stressed out about the newest cybernetic enhancement to my ear holes. Why not just tweezers? I don't think I had tweezers. I still don't think I have tweezers. Who the hell tweezes anymore? What the fuck are you gonna tweeze? I guess that out of my ear. Alright, Guzzo, fair enough, you got me. Anyway, now I've had the opposite problem, where I'm walking down the street the other day, I'm on the corner, and I come across an acquaintance of mine. Now, it's hard to recognize people nowadays with the masks on, but I'm like, yo, you know what, I think that's Joe. That's my man, Joe. So to be polite, just say hi, because I haven't seen him in like a year, I take out one earbud, and I say, hey, what's brackin', how you living? And he's like, hey, what's up? And then it's kind of an awkward conversation, where we both, want it to end and just want to say, alright, have a good one. But neither of us properly... Was that 10? I think that was 8. Oh, give me a moment. I knew you were going to say Joe Mama. I set you up for that. 9. 10. Alright. Whew. How do I get these fine eyebrows without tweezers? I pull them out individually one by one in my sleep. It's my nervous tick. Nah, baby. These are naturally grown. These are free-range eyebrows right here. Whew! Not how I was expecting to start the stream. Oh, fuck, did I forget water? Alright, y'all, remember to remind me to hydrate. In a bit. In a tick. Whew, yeah, this shit's all organic. Straight up. What was I talking about? So I take the thing out of my ear. I'm like, hey, what's up? It's one of those conversations where you haven't seen each other in a while, you don't have much in common, you just kind of want to acknowledge each other's existence, but you don't just say, hey, what's poppin', have a good one, because then he's like, hey, it's been a while, how you doing? And I was like, I'm doing well, how about you? And he's like, I'm doing all right, I didn't realize you lived down here. And then I point to my house, because we're very close to it. I'm like, I live right there. And then he's like, damn it, spaceman. He's like, oh, that's sick, I live down here. And now we are in a conversation, because we have talked about our geographic locations. It is no longer just a friendly hello and goodbye. I have nothing else to say. I want to get home. I was listening. I had my earbuds in. I'm not trying to converse right now. There's a reason I was listening to my jams. But politely, I took out one earbud. I said hi to him. We have now salutated and engaged in conversation. So I awkwardly am like, all right, man, I hope you keep doing well. I got a blast. Jimmy Neutron got a bust. And then I head out of there. I get back home. I never put the earbud back in because I'm like literally 30-second walk from my house. I could point to it from where we had the conversation. And he's like, well, he's like nothing. He's gone. I get home. I get inside. I finally set all my shit down. Try to put my earbud in. Yeah, I got it, Poyos. I can read. Contrary to popular belief, I am literate. Just only when it's inconvenient to me. You guys are getting a nice insight into my room, which is only neat because I had intruders. Thanks, fucking landlord. We'll get to that. Oh my god. My anger's fueling me. Oh, fuck landlords. Woo! Jesus, Salmon. Wait, did Poyos redeem a third bout of push-ups? It didn't show up in my chat. He said do more push-ups, but did he redeem it? Sometimes Stream Elements goes big doo-doo dumb brain. Just let me know if I'm skamazing anybody, because we don't skamaz here. You're close to push-ups? Oh no, Gozo. Say hi to the dog for me. What kind of dog you got? Could have had another push-up thing, but you won't because you feel bad for me. See, there's where it's at. True Turkey Durkey viewers are at the level of pity. That's the environment we're trying to foster here. You didn't redeem more? Just know you could. All right. I feel like there's a Ludwig gun in the subtext of that sentence. So I put my earbud back in, and sure enough, it's like this. No jelly cap. And God fucking damn it, I just can't use it again. I go outside, it's starting to drizzle. I retrace my steps, staring at the ground like I'm fucking depressed. Crossing the street, eyes only to the ground, probably would have gotten hit by a car. Luckily, I was fine, but unluckily, I can't use my earbud. And the way these operate, right? This one interfaces with my phone, and then this one interfaces with this one. So I can't just ditch this piece of shit because it has no jelly. I have to like hold it so I can listen with the right one. I can't just listen with one ear. I gotta like, oh yeah, I'm listening to my bangers or some dumb shit. It blows. Oh my God, chat. Holy fuck. Oh my God, guys, I just had a revelation. Holy shit, you're never gonna believe this. Holy fucking shit. Check this out. Right? Okay. Yo! What the fuck, dude? Whoa! Yes! Woo! Thank you, China! Thank you, Twitch! Thank you, America! Wow. How did I not fucking think of that all day yesterday? That should just lend credence to the fact that it has been a couple days. Stop hacking. Boys, it's all down here, downhill from here. It's all down here from hill. Oh, shit. Whew. Wah, 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 wah. I like a lot. Oh, man. Yeah, so that's that. Wow, dude, problem solved. I can just ditch this earbud now. Holy shit. Oh, I'm ecstatic. It's all down here from this hill. Oh, my God. Whew. I'm getting all hot and bothered. Wow, I really wish I could run my fan while streaming. The sacrifices I make for Twitch. Oh, man. Alright, so my fucking landlord, right? It's like 10:15 p.m. last night. All my roommates get a text individually on our phone. Our theory is that he has a service set up where he can send out the same text to multiple people, but if we message back, it only goes to him. Interesting, but whatever. And it's an unregistered number in my phone, which is strange because I swear I registered him as a contact, as did all of us when we signed the house. Little sketch. But he sends a message saying like, hey, are you guys planning on living in the house next year? I've got an interested party that wants to tour the place at 7:30 tomorrow night. This is yesterday night. And we're like, no, actually, we're also looking for people to pass the place down onto, because we're trying to keep it, if we can, keep this house in the Drumline family as a nice little Drumline property. Gozo, excellent question. Once I get my game show up and running, they're my first victims. I even talked to them. I got verbal consent, and that is admissible in a court of law, baby. Woo! Now I can do whatever I want to them. You'll meet them. When are you a victim? We could do a viewer one. We're getting ahead of ourselves. I still have a shitload of planning to do. I need to scrap together a couple of shekels, pay someone on Fiverr to make like an overlay and a logo for it, maybe. Depends on how professional we're trying to be. Anyway, you got me off track. What was I talking about? The landlord. So we're like, yeah, that's fine. 7:30 p.m. tomorrow. That's a little cringe. You're going to invite 6 people into our house while we're also in it. And there's a global pandemic. Could we just give them a virtual tour? Or work out some kind of compromise? And he's like, oh, no, you won't be in it. You got to get the fuck out. He basically sends a text saying, yo, no, this is non-negotiable. I need you out of the house at 7:30 p.m. Tuesday. thanks for understanding. And then we're like, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, there's six of us and one of you. There's a fucking worldwide pandemic. I feel like we should reach some kind of middle ground. So we text him, and then we're like, hey, is it now a good time to call him? We shoot him a phone call. No response. We're like, all right, we agree to wake up at 8 this morning. Give him a text. Give him a call. See if he can respond. Fucking nothing. Although I wouldn't know because I slept through my alarm at 8 this morning. Sorry. I flaked. I'll say it. I was unreliable today. We all have those days, and it has been a day. Just come on all of the furniture to scare them off, and then replace your light bulbs with a black light and make the whole place look like a Jackson Pollock painting, a purple one. They could just watch this, yeah, and they'll see one of the rooms. Unfortunately, it doesn't come with this lovely art painted by yours truly. I also am the creator of Calvin and Hobbes. Wouldn't you know it? Little known fact, twitch.tv/turkeydurkey. I'm Bill Watterson, baby. It was my secret disguise, my alter ego. So we call him, one of my roommates who is the whole liaison for this thing. Shout out to him, by the way. Basically communing between us and the landlord this whole time. Was like, yo, you gave us less than 24 hours notice. Now you're booting us out of the house. What is up? You're also ghosting us. Can we get some kind of confirmation or some shit? Can we get some communication? And then like... earlier this afternoon, he calls back. But in the meantime, I had been talking with my girlfriend, and I knew she was looking at houses around the area. Excuse me. For, her own living situation next year. And I knew she was interested in this place because she needs a six-person house. They're a little rare in this region because a six-person house, by dogshit Indiana corn-crazy law, you can't have more than, I think it's five people who aren't related in one house. So my house has actually two addresses, and it's two units stacked on top of each other with two kitchens and then three separate rooms. It's like such a stupid loophole for such a stupid rule. So it's technically two houses, but we're talking to my girlfriend, and I'm like, I swear she said she was touring houses on Thursday, but she's like, yeah, actually, I'm going to swing by tomorrow night to tour if that's cool. And we put the pieces together, and we're like, oh, fuck, did you talk to the landlord? You're the group coming to tour. So luckily, we get a hold of the landlord. We're like, hey, we know the people who are coming to tour. Can I just sit in my house and do homework? I know these people. I'm comfortable with them. But it was such a dick move. So he finally calls, or... receives our call and is like, okay, you know them personally, you could stay. But cringe, I'm really worried about, we need to get it sorted for the next time he has someone interested in this house, because my girlfriend and her friends are not going to be the only interested party, and I'm not trying to get kicked out of my house, let in six strangers and the landlord to come cough on everything and aerosolize the air with their COVID breath. And I don't know, sometimes you could tour a house, you could steal a little... take a little cheeky snog from something in someone's room. Nobody would ever know, right? I would feel uncomfortable letting six strangers in my house unsupervised. Maybe that's an unsavory opinion, but I would rather not vacate the whole house. What if they cop my one functioning Chinese knockoff Raycons? What would I do with myself? Then I would have zero functioning Chinese knockoff Raycons. I'm up Schitt's Creek without a paddle. Foxy, my man, why is the alert not working? My overlay's off. Oh no, chat's been off the whole time. Oh, there's my name tag. Hello, welcome to the stream. Wow, I really screwed the pooch on this one. Wow, wah wah wee wah. Goodness me, he got two dubs? Yeah, buddy! Is that two in addition to the one or two total? Either way, fucking killer, man. I only have two dubs. Yeah, dude. Just Vox climbing the ranks of the Fall Guys ladder. If you've never seen him, twitch.tv/justvoxpop. He's a homie. Camera, please focus. Camera. There we go. Thanks, Tropics. Appreciate it. What was I talking about? Oh, yeah. Sketchy landlord shit. Not a fan. Wish he could communicate, give us more than 24 hours notice, be a little bit more cool when there's a fucking global pandemic sweeping the nation and we're in an epicenter of pandemic, a college campus. There are some dogshit stupid people here, man. I seen a a guy running down the street earlier today, and I had to like put my keys into my door a little bit quicker because I didn't want him to run past me. He got no mask and no shirt. I don't give a fuck if your titties is hanging out, but if you got your big, big, sloppy, wet lips hanging out in the open air and you're running past me, breathing heavily from your fucking jog, no thank you, bro. Breathe on someone else. Excuse me. What's up, Bixby? Peepo hey, my friend. Peepo hey to everybody. Oh my god, two dubs from my boy. Your house walls tested positive for meth? Is that real or is this a hypothetical situation? Because that's crazy. How can you even... Do you smoke meth? I thought you inject... My repressed, sheltered, suburban white kid is showing. If you smoke it, then I guess, yeah, it would be in the walls a little bit. How the fuck do you test a wall for drugs? Let me take a nice lick of your wall. Oh, yep. That's meth. Fresh meth. The wind direction? Southbound. Oh, man. I think I vented about everything I want to vent about. Man, life's weird now. Being a senior is crazy. Because now I've found myself in all the extracurriculars that I've normally done. I'm now in a leadership role. And that's cringe, dude. Imagine having to take orders from fucking little old me. I wouldn't do it. I would revolt. I would say, hell nah, what authority do you have? You're just a fucking Twitch.television streamer. That's cringe in and of itself. You test walls for drugs before you sell the place? I guess I should have tested it before I rented it, because definitely some sketchy shit has gone down in this house. There's a room in the basement that's like... It's like this wide, right? The whole room. It's just like a little tunnel in the back. You have to go all the way around the sea of the house in the basement to get to it. And it's like pitch black. I could almost guarantee you there's a body in there. But I wouldn't know. I'm not fucking touching it. Because if you find the body, you gotta report it. And then people are like, oh, you're probably the imposter. I bet it was a self-report. And then I'm like, fucking no, dude. I just want to stream and paint yeets on my wall. Poyos got his nuggies. Now the stream can start, fellas. I was just stalling till Poyos got his nuggies. What shape? What shape? That's very important. Taste? That's alright. Mouth feel? That's alright. Nuggy shape? The most important aspect of nuggy connoisseurship. You got dinosaur? You got all four of McDonald's categories. What? Bell, boot, ball. Bell boot ball. Bing. Bell boot ball. Bexus. There's a nugget that's shaped like Texas. Bell boot ball. Bong. What the fuck is the fourth one? Bell boot ball. Guys, I got nothing. I literally cannot think of it. But it starts with a B. Bell boot ball bazinga. My favorite nugget shape. It's a lightning bolt. It's shaped like Sheldon himself from critically acclaimed television show The Bing Bong Theory. Yeah, there's actually designated shapes for McDonald's nuggets. They're divided into four categories. It's crazy. I found it out recently and I was like, fucking why? You just take some paste and you squirt it into a thing and you cover it in bread. You sell it for like 10 cents. You really expect me to believe there's a method to this madness? Just let me shove your pink paste directly into my system. I don't want to know the science behind it. Bone. What? Bone? That's gross. I don't want to think about bones in my meat paste. One of my roommates bought Spam recently. What the fuck is up with Spam? Have any of you guys had Spam in chat? No, don't spam in chat. Do not spam in chat. That was a question, not a command. Oh, fuck. Oh, no. I didn't think that went through. Spam's disgusting to me. It's like sausage links, but... Sibby, I'm not on a mental wavelength. I'm not prepared for that kind of philosophical content. It's like sausage... Whatever the hell sausage is made of, right? Just meat amalgamation, but then condensed and shoved into a can. Do you slice it, or do you just scoop it? Like, what is the consistency? Is it like ice cream, but meat? Nothing gets my appetite going like meat paste. I tell you what, do you put it on a sandwich? Call it a spamwich? You put it on a burger? Call it a spam burger? Damn, I was on a roll. I can't think of a third one. Is a pate. It's like malleable sausage. Okay, fair enough. Yeah, I guess you could like spread it on a cracker. That sounds grody though. Bixby, you can't call him that. Oh my god. What the fuck? Monka. It's better than ham. Ham can be hit or miss. Ham is the good shit when you get them at the deli to just fucking go crazy on it with a grater or the slicer or whatever and turn it into little strips. Just like rip it as much as you can. Then ham, that's the fucking good, dude. You cannot top that. Oh, salmon's got a copyright on the word spurg, apparently. I wouldn't. Look, you say what you want, but I would not step on salmon's turf. He's peed all over that shit. He's learned from the lessons of our primal ancestors. You pissed to mark your territory. That's what I should have done to keep the people out of my house. That's what I should do right now. I got no pee to pee. I'm all out of pee. Chat, can you lend me your pee? Cringe. Is that Marsh? What's up? Wait, what the fuck? Hey, Marsh. Wait, it's not what it looks like, I swear. Guys, what the? My chat on OBS isn't updating. I can only see chat here. And it expires pretty rapidly. Pissing on them is smarter. Oh my god, we could Macaulay Culkin this shit. Home Alone, right? I'll put a bucket above the door with just full of my own urine, dude. Can you buy urine? Because I'm out of pee, like we said. I do need to hydrate, by the way. Remind me to get a glass of water when we're off this talking point, right? Could I just, oh my god, you put a paragraph and it's gonna expire in 10 seconds. I know a dude who invited a homeless man to sleep on the living room floor on the day of a home visit. That's charitable. I mean, he probably had good intentions. You could buy coyote piss. Why can you buy, why coyotes of all animals? Oh, because they're like predators, you could scare shit away. What the fuck did I join to? We're figuring out ways to keep strangers out of my house because my landlord is just, my landlord's going brazy bears. He's going ham. He has reserved the right to kick us out of our house at any time interval to just let people in and take a tour. Easy piss on the door. I was thinking about that, right? But then I got two doors to piss on. Are you saying like piss around the door frame and then it's like a sea bear circle from SpongeBob where they can't enter it anymore? What's up, Speedy? He's going ham, Lord. Landlord going ham, Lord. Bars. Combine urea and ammonia. It looks and smells like uber cat piss. I'm assuming urea is in urine. Urea, urethra, urine, Uranus. They're all related, baby. Wow, it's so easy. It's like six degrees of relationship. How you can say like, I know I'm within 6 degrees of Snoop Dogg. You can relate anything to piss. Piss is within 6 degrees of Uranus. Oh, take all the doors off again, Vox. You're not supposed to remember that. That was a dark time. Those shit, dude, doors are fucking heavy, man. The sacrifices I make. I brought 4 doors up from the bottom floor. Or from the basement, bottom floor. I'm on the bottom floor. Uramatopoeia. Dude, I remember loving spelling the word onomatopoeia. Because I would just sound it out in my head. I was like, oh, fuck yeah, dude. Spelling bee time. Or spelling pop quiz in class. Onomatopoeia. 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 It's just a fun one to pronounce in your head. Don't make fun of me. Degrees of bacon. Yeah, 6 degrees from Kevin Bacon. That was a dark time. After putting that clip in his. Yeah, all right. Fair enough, Vox. Sometimes you got to capitalize on your darkness. You got to set up OBS stuff. If I want to do something, I will hit you up. Maybe some Fall Guys. I'm thinking some Fall Guys later. Oh, fuck. I'm about to fall again. All right. What were we talking about? Wow, we just went on tangent after tangent after tangent. I'm impressed. remember how to spell it normally because you're built different. Oh, you probably just have it written down in front of you. Or you've got like Ned's Declassified Survival Guide. You've got that little thing that flips down and then he just goes fucking, he's like, what was that show? That show with that guy? Oh my god, what's the actor who looks like Dax Shepard but isn't Dax Shepard? Chuck! Chuck, where he's like a super nerd and then he eats a computer or some shit. And then he's like, I am now hacked into Google. Enhance! Enhance! You are part of the Google machine. Google, show me this woman naked. Zoom. Enhance. That's my review of Chuck, the television show. What the fuck were we talking about? Spy Kids? Oh, the thing with Cookie where he does that and then his brain just turns into like the entire knowledge of humanity and then he's like, oh yeah, O-N-A-M-A-T-O-P-O-E-I-A or some shit. I probably didn't spell that right. I need a drink. Alcohol or water? Alcohol or water? Ah, the age-old question. Alcohol and water. I'll be white black. What the fuck is vodka water? Is that a thing? That's just diluted vodka. Are you really mixing vodka with water? Just get shittier, cheaper vodka. Ooh. Oh man. Does wine expire? Wine doesn't expire, right? That's the whole point of wine, is that it's like, the more expired the wine is, the better it is. Tuscany. 1872. My ancestors fought over it in the French-American War. And a single droplet was spilled on his waistcoat. We then siphoned the droplet and put it in a glass. Wine doesn't expire unless you open it. I did open it. I did do that. Did I do a bad? I mean, you gotta open it to drink it, which I did like a month ago. It just tastes stronger. Is that because there's, like, expired grape in it? Drink, 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 drink. I'm not gonna chug it, dude. I'm almost out of wine. Oh, it'd be fucking fun, though. No, I've done enough alcoholism streams. Spaceman, fucking, I have a whole video about how stream chat made me an alcoholic. Exclamation point YouTube. Whoa, that was crazy. Did you guys hear that? That's so weird. No sweat, Speedy. Sorry for overloading your processing system. Wine is already expired, grape. Okay, so it's all good, right? I'm Gucci. I'm only poisoning my body in one way and not two, right? That's the true question here. Should I double fist? Health? And wealth. How many words rhyme with health? Health and stealth, baby. Thank you.
that's fucking gross.
Ugh. Oh, I can't believe you guys talked me into that. Why'd you make me do that shit? What were you thinking? Overwatch carry is too important. Who do you play? Oh man, this is some good shit. Chat, I want to read you some shit. I want to read you some... Wait, I need to find a spot to put my drinks. Move, water bottle. This is now the drink station for my liquids. Very nice. Oh my god, Rosalina's Observatory, dude. One of the first, like, non-classical songs I learned on piano. It's like pseudo-classical, but you know what I mean. It's not fucking Haydn or Beethoven. It's none of those crusty old guys. Koji Kondo himself, the man, the myth, the legend. What a fitting song to play right after the announcement that Galaxy's coming to Switch. Dude, everything I think about that, every time I think about that, just gives me a little... You know? That's some good shit. That's my childhood right there. Being bottled up, repackaged, making me spend money for a product I've already bought. But I get to play it on Switch, which means I get to play with my girlfriend and introduce new people into this part of my life that they've never seen before. I don't know. Maybe I'm a little too sentimental. But it's video games, man. We just sit here on Twitch all day. It's part of our fucking identity. The amount of Overwatch I play and how much I enjoy my life are inversely correlated. I feel like that's most competitive video games. You just described Overwatch, League of Leggings, Dota, actually literally any MOBA. Speedrunning. No, speedrunning's kind of sick. Speedrunning's kind of dope. Sounds pretty gay. You got me, dude. I've been exposed live on Twitch.television. I've been destroyed. Oh my god. Whoa! He said the gay word. LMAO. Dude, he said the funny word. You assume I enjoy my addiction to Overwatch. Yeah, see? Straight from the horse's mouth, baby. That shit's crazy. Why is my camera out of wonk? De-wonk yourself, young man. There we go. Much better. See, now the stream is quality. Turkey Turkey Minecraft RP, oh, it'll happen. You put me in a room, you lock me in a room, and give me enough time with Twitch, it'll happen. Roblox stream, that shit's coming up at some point. Ah, it's only inevitable. What's up, Mr. Jelly, my lord himself? How you doing? You gotta go again? Godspeed, good luck with your overwatchings. Okay, well, wait. I think there, we've done a little bit of mental gymnastics here from putting our Minecraft beds next to each other. BDSM, of course, stands for Big Dog Super Mario. It's wholesome. It's family friendly. Call me an Olympian. You're a mental Olympian, dude. They have that shit, right? The Science Olympiad, baby. That's you. You're the Achilles of Science Olympiad. I was the RuneScape girlfriend. Oh, guys, are you really gonna make me? I haven't drank enough wine to tell you this shit. All right, chat. Fucking look me in the eyes right now. What happens on twitch.tv/turkeydurkey? Stays on twitch.tv/turkeydurkey. Put your hand over your heart and fucking repeat that shit. This is a sacred bond, brothers. Yeah, that's what BDSM stands for. Bible discussion and study meetings. All right, hand over your forehead. That works, baby. I'll take a 17 for the boys. Give me 100k coins in RuneScape and I'll be your girlfriend. All right. Now, I never played RuneScape as a kid. God, oh god, oh god, it's all fucking flooding back to me. I never played RuneScape, but I did play Wizards 101, and you know, just like how Mark Zuckerberg, he's beaten life, right? He's fucking won. He's even beaten the endgame. He's got so much money he doesn't know what to do with. So he goes around slathering sunscreen on his face, smoking up briskets, and sitting on his waveboard showing off his cake. Because once you've beaten the game, what else is there to do? You gotta make your own fun. Now, I played a lot of Wizard 101. So much so that I had beaten the final boss and the end game, the post game. I had beaten fucking everything under the sun until they wiped everything. Yo, rest in peace, Blaze Dawnblade, my boy. I spent hundreds of hours with that boy. That young, young pyromancer boy. You remember beating Malastare at age 10, think you were the coolest? Malastare is the bottom of the bucket. Because once you've gotten a character max level, once you've seen all there is to see within the game's code and everything you can possibly do, you start seeing all there is to see with the people who play the game. Enter my second character, a chick wizard. Oh, fuck, dude, I played the tutorial, and then I just went into the first world, which is like the hub world where everybody hangs out, and I don't remember, but I just started questing with this dude, and I shit you not, I fucking catfished someone on Wizard 101. I fucking actually, that's how I found out about Justin Bieber, actually. The dude was trying to romance me. He was like, you ever heard of Justin Bieber? But you couldn't type the chat. The Wizard 101 chat had a very, very strong profanity filter where any word you said had to be like a real word. And last names, those aren't words. So he had to type Justin By, and then the word bear. And I was like, what the fuck are you saying to me? Who's Justin By Bear? And then like 3 days later, Justin Bieber blew up. And I'm in this dude's Wizard 101 house. We're both on the tutorial level, so he's got dog shit, man. If I'm gonna catfish some wizard, I should have catfished some dude with a giant wizard mansion who's summoning like dragons and shit. What was I doing? Damn, hindsight 2020. But I remember chatting to this dude for a long fucking time. Keep in mind, I'm like 11. In hindsight, it was probably an adult, but no, I doubt it. Nobody asks, do you know fucking Justin Bieber? It was definitely a fellow kid. No crimes were committed, just a lot of weird champ shit. Okay? Mark my words. Oh my god, I don't remember everything. I just remember fucking wasting this guy's time and getting a kick out of it. But then I was like, you know what? I'm done with this dude. He's got fucking nothing in his house. He's poor as shit. He got no wizard money. He got no mana. What is he gonna do for a woman? You gotta earn this cake. You gotta earn this Mark Zuckerberg dumpy. I was trying to steal his welfare. No, his welfare wasn't good enough for me. So I cast a spell. I was like, you know what? The way I'm going to end this, I'm going to flexicute on this guy. So I added him on my other character and was like, hey, it's me. But wait, I'm still a girl. I just did my first playthrough on a male character and max leveled it. Trust me, I swear. And that's the point where I think even like a little 12-year-old can figure out something's a little fucking fishy. Peepo G, yes, you just felt like experimenting with the male customization options, so you got level 60 in Wizard 101 and beat the final boss on a male character. Yes, math checks out. Damn, Simmy! Whoa! Fucking slay, Simmy pulls. Oh, man. Hey, that's sick. I mean, if it's like a genuine relationship and you guys have spoken to each other, there's nothing wrong with meeting people through digital means. There's so many couples where you watch Minecon cringe compilations or whatever when those were huge, and every year there's like a proposal, and it's always kind of cringy because everybody there is like 8 years old except for this couple. There's kids in the back that are dabbing, but like I don't think a proposal is cringe, right? That's just two people. She cheated on me. That's fucking cringe. That's cringe compilation 2020, baby. Wow, pour one out for Sibby. Dude, I'm so sorry. Wow, holy shit. You just hit me with the 1-2 sucker punch. Damn, dude. I tell you what, though. That is such a fucking good story. I'm sure it's not worth all the heartbreak and I'm sure all the emotional trauma and shit that you went through. I'm sorry to hear that all that happened. But what a kick-ass story, bro. Now you can pick up all the other chicks saying, yeah, I met this Moira main, and we just hit it off, brother. I was spamming need medic, and then she started spamming need medic, and then one thing led to another, and she fucking cheated on me. Salmon, what the fuck? Oh, boys support boys. Don't listen to Salmon. Oh my god. Oh man. The stereotypical. Were you the Mercy main or was she? This is an important question. There is a correct answer. And once you answer, I will tell you something about myself when I played Overwatch. She was a Mercy main. I fucking was too, baby. I got no skill. I'm dog shit at first person shooters. But I found Mercy. I was like, I can support my teammates. I can kind of aim in their general. Sibby's got his priorities straight. I would rather have a fucking competent Mercy than get my dick wet. Respect, Sibby. Now you know. Sibby has passed the gamer test. One of us. One of us. Oh my god. Dude, I can't breathe. Oh, not like this. Holy shit, Sibby. Damn. Get you a man who will throw away his Overwatch competitive rank for you. Holy shit. Thank you for sharing that with the class, Sibby. I'm sorry for all that you went through. But you suffered so that we could learn from your mistakes, and I admire that. Oh my god. Sibby rolled with a trash Mercy for 2 years for our sins. What a fucking legend. What a legend. Never gonna be gold again. Not with that attitude. You know how you can get top rank in Overwatch right now? So you go up to the application, right? You open battle.net. And then instead of opening it, you hit uninstall. No shade on Overwatch players. It's a good game. It's nothing, like, spectacular in my opinion, but excuse me. Also, not a huge first-person shooter guy. I think I used up all my first-person shooter juices on TF2. Because that was, like, the first PC game, other than Portal 2. But that was, like, the first real PC game that I ever played, and my god, I poured hours into Team Fortress 2 as a kid. I never, like, got competitive or learned anything about the meta of the game. First fucking PC game I ever played. But damn, TF2 was some good shit. So then Overwatch came out, and I was like, yeah, it just seems like kind of a TF2 rip with better writing and better character design. Because if there's one thing Overwatch has going for it, I think we can all agree, it's the character design, right? That's just good. I mean, it's just, they're likable. They all have interesting motivations and interesting backgrounds. It's just the gameplay that I'm personally not a huge fan of. Spaceman, oh, he's playing some Smite. You get that Avatar state, Aang, my man. Good luck. I don't know shit about Smite, but I do know shit about Avatar. And Aang is cool, and also bald. Have some fun, brother. Thanks for coming out. You'll always have a love for TF2, even though you don't play it anymore. Sibby, I'm in the exact same boat. I feel exactly the same way, man. Even though I probably won't play it for years, maybe I'll hop in, play one round of Spy, poke a couple people in the back. But yeah, I probably won't play that for years. Oh man, for some machine, that was some good shit. Salmon, take it out of the oven, baby. What's BSS? Be back soon. Be sexy, sir. You feel old. Dude, nothing wrong with liking a little TF2. That shit's good. Sometimes I'll still listen to the soundtrack because it had such a unique aesthetic and sound. I love TF2. All right. There was some shit I wanted to read you. We have gotten Mondo Ultra Mega sidetracked, but I'm having the time of my life. You guys can always cheer a boy up. I appreciate you. First, we need a different tone of music. Whoa, what are you doing, Spotify? You're playing random stuff that's arguably copyrighted. Not arguably, that's not a subjective thing. All right, where's some good shit? There we go. All right. Oh, the Bajan Canadian. I was just thinking about old Minecrafters. I started watching Funhouse again recently, because their shit is so good. I'll tell you exactly why. It's because the other day, me and my roommates were talking about the game show we're gonna host, and then one of them brought up Talking Stockings, the Funhouse, like, shit show clusterfuck, as scuffed as possible fake podcast they do about some old show from the 80s, Silk Stockings. And man, it's so good. Dean, my man, always comes to every stream swinging. He's got his shotgun loaded with sexually aggressive compliments, and every time, I appreciate you, brother. All right, what were we about to do? Oh, you know what? Me just a moment. Is the music too loud? I think maybe just an ounce. Just a tick. There we go. All right, chat. My train of thought keeps fucking derailing. Oh, I gotta open my browser. That's what's up. All right, chat room. Now, before we go forward with the stream, I'd like to go way back. Chair folded up on me. Oh, it was not worth it. No, no feet. No feet. Well, fuck. If nobody else thinks I'm funny, I think I'm fucking hilarious. You shut your whore mouths. Feet. Feet. I sacrifice my life for the momentum of the stream. And all you can talk about is feet. God damn it. Oh, whatever. I'll just entertain myself now. I don't need chat. I don't need you brat bastards. Guys, you're supposed to validate my self-esteem. Okay. So I was talking to an old friend who's graduated now, but he came back to campus to visit. He said it was to visit his girlfriend, but I know it was to hang out with the boy. Bros before hoes. You know how it goes. Misters before sisters. And we were talking about these reviews he found online for sugar-free gummy bears, a specific brand of sugar-free gummy bears that are imported from like Sweden or some shit. Okay, wait. Before we get to this, let me put up the green screen, 'cause we're shifting gears. Let's put on some. There we go. Jams. Actual jams. Let's put up the green screen. You got feet, now you get dumpy. You're getting the whole smorgasbord this stream. You guys better be grateful. Sibbe! There it is. It worked. Now I just have to touch my elbows together and write your name on my bits board. Ooh, I am Sibby. Thank you, Sibby. You're the one for me. The more I read into the paragraph, the funnier it gets. Hey, anything for you, my man. Don't mention it. But I'm just saying, don't mention it so I seem humble and chill and laid back. But I do want you to mention it. I want you to mention it profusely so you make me look like a good person. But I want you to mention it unprompted so therefore I also make myself look like a good person. And dude, they'll never see it coming, bro. I'm the king. I'm the king. King into castle. King into castle. You do this. Wah wah wee wah. Oh, thanks for the bits, buddy. I appreciate it. Every little bit helps, pun intended. Do you think that's why they made it? They called it that? Nah, they're just like, yo, you know what? Gamers like cool terms with like short, punchy, one syllable things. Well, they're small. They're small little purchases, bro. It's equivalent to 1 cent. Let's call it a bit. Yeah, actually, I like streamers who used to be employees at Twitch, so maybe I shouldn't generalize the entire Twitch staff as an amalgamation of chats. Stick my butt out again. Hey, this show ain't free, baby. You gotta pay for the royal treatment. Oh shit, I forgot to take the... Oh, this was the most awkward part of having people come over to the house, is I had to explain to people why I have paper clips hanging from the ceiling that look like sex dungeon chains. Excuse me? I can't wait to do that to actual strangers and not friends that know I stream on the side. Alright, let's get the whole ensemble together, buddy. Halfway there, I got 6 of these things. I had to go to Target, I had to go to Walmart, risk life and limb. You just had a sudden urge for some cake. Well, Sippy paid for it, so. Oops. Guys, what the fuck have I become? You either die the gaming streamer, or you live long enough to see yourself become the big booty just chatting streamer. Oh my god. What the fuck? I've degraded so quickly. I've been at this for fucking 4 months, and you already got me showing my cake. That was supposed to be my ultimate weapon. That was supposed to be a weapon to surpass Metal Gear. You guys got me revealing it day one. I got a smooth talking chat. Y'all got silver tongues. Alright, 4 out of 6. We almost there, boys. One of these paperclips is backwards and so frustrating. But I'm also too lazy to fix it. Boom. Alright, green screen is up. No huge creases except for the spot where it meets my bed. Which is always a clusterfuck. I got shafted. I got the small room. It's 9 by 10 and that's inches, not feet. I lost. Alright, the screen is up. The lighting looks alright. Let's see. Wow, having green behind me really washes me out. Holy shit. I thought I took auto white balance off the camera. Well, did I turn the chroma key off? Oh, what a fool I've been all these years. All Twitch streaming is glorified prostitution. Couldn't have said it better myself. Especially gaming streaming. Chroma key. Ah, oh, it's be... Yo, what the fuck happened to my toupee? The white balance screwed up, and now the... Oh my god, I told it to lock the fucking... Oh, Sibby. Oh, that's... I might clap my cheeks together and make a shockwave for that. Oh, it's 2 a.m.? Oh my god, it is. Hey, well, thanks for staying up this late to hang with the boys. It's nice to see you, Sibby. Is that an animated Craigasm? Oh, that is just awful. That is just foul. I love it. Thanks, Sibby. You have a good night. Thanks for the free pleasure. All glory holes are glorified Twitch streaming? How far around this loop, this circular logic? Can we get 8 degrees away from prostitution and glory holes? Why'd I say 8? We were just talking about it. It's 6. Why is my hair like that? Alright, well, we gotta adjust the chroma key settings. Though, how could the lighting have changed? I literally don't know what could have possibly changed. Maybe my hair is just too long now and it picks up more green from the screen. What the frick? Pardon my French, but now we got like Mondo artifacting on the... Wait a second. Oh, that's gross. Oh, I hate that. Oh, get it out of there. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, the first part of the problem is the fact that the green screen's not even the center of the frame. So I've got real world leaking out. That's issue number A. There we go. Now let's see what we can get. Man, this is just about as scuffed as it gets. This is the talking stockings of Twitch streams right here. Alright, that'll do. You will not be defeated on the bits. Now undo two buttons, so I'll be like... Okay. Alright, Dean. I'll undo the bottom one. You'll never see it. My evil plan. And I'll undo this one for you. Oldest trick in the book, baby. You know what? I'll give you an extra button just for the boys. Pop the collar. I'm sweating. I am sweating, dude. It's fucking hot in here. I really wish I could run the fan. Why did I have to string the green screen right in the spot where the fan is? Oh, yeah, boys. Now we're out here. All right. I think that's the best, like, green screen halo effect we're going to... Oh, my armpits are just radiating. It's like I used Chernobyl brand deodorant. What the fuck? Alright, we'll up the similarity just a touch. I hope it doesn't take out too much of my hair. I need to get a haircut anyway. This will just be a synthetic digital haircut. It's like CGI. Alright, that'll take some more troubleshooting off stream. But that's cringe. How did that happen? How did my lighting change? I don't know what parameter could have possibly changed. Do I have low latency mode disabled? My stream delay is insane. Yeah, I was noticing that. I was noticing that with the chat. There's like Mondo Uber stream delay. I don't know what the issue is. I definitely... Low latency mode I don't think is on the broadcaster end. That's on the recipient end, right? Or am I wrong about that? I definitely did not change that setting, but let's see. Stream. No. Output. No, it's definitely what it always has been. Bitrate 3500 kilobits per second. I think what it is my internet adapter, which is on its side right now, by the way, which is no bueno, is really inconsistent. So at some points it'll broadcast like literally 9000 kilobits per second for some reason, but at other points it'll throttle back to like 1000, which is way below what I want to be running at. So I think every time it does that, the stream kind of hiccups until it can get back to a reasonable bitrate. And then it'll upload what it missed. And then every time that happens, it'll just keep kicking back the stream. So you'll have to keep refreshing. That would be my... That's my theory, at least. I got actually no clue why it's so delayed. Holy shit. It really is delayed. That's crazy. It's bad. Wow. There's a low latency mode on Twitch. Is that on the broadcaster side? I definitely have that enabled if I do. I'm pretty sure that's on the recipient side where you check that for... Maybe not. Fuck it. Let's go into the stream settings. I want this to be as good as we can get it. Definitely worth a double check since we're having this trouble. This is a major risk going into stream settings live, but let's peep. Here we go. Oh, I'm a fool. There it is. All right. They say it can affect quality, but no one really notices. Oh my God, it's over 30 seconds. Yeah, that's actually genuinely ridiculous. I don't know what the issue is there. Let's see if it's here. It's not there. It's deeper in, I think it's actual settings. That is ridiculous. Channel and videos. Oh, do not show the stream key. Yeah, low latency. I think it's on my, That's on my broadcasting, like, my internet. That's the only thing I could come up with. It would definitely help from the recipient side to refresh. That's the only, like, short-term solution I can come up with right now, but I will maybe make like a Twitch test broadcast channel and just screw with it. I've been thinking about what I think I'm gonna do is just get a, like a 100-foot Ethernet cable and hardwire myself into the router and just snake it over the ceiling, like over the top of the door, all the way down the hall to the living room. Because luckily I'm on the same floor as the router. One of my roommates has done a pretty interesting solution that I've never heard of, where you wire the router itself into an adapter that goes into the coax cable of the house. So if you watch things on cable, it would be conflicting with the TV, but we don't even have cable. Like, we literally don't watch live TV. So it completely hijacks the coax cable running through the house and uses that as essentially a ghetto Ethernet cable. And it's been working really well for him. That's pretty sick. The only issue is it's dummy expensive. Like, one adapter is $60. So for two, it'd be $120 for me to get this shit up and running. Kinda cringe. I still have to order a chair because we hit our chair sub goal. Ooh, maybe we should pick out a chair. One thing at a time, okay? Speaking of shopping, there are these sugar-free gummy bears on Amazon, and I would like to read you some of the reviews because they give me such joy. Right? Test. All right, let me know how bad it is. I hope it's not like 30 seconds. You can do that with your power too. I've tried it with power line adapters. It hasn't worked as well for me. It worked at my old house, kinda. That's where I was streaming over the summer with a power line adapter, and it was tolerable. Here it didn't work as well. I'm not sure why. Maybe we just use a lot of the power line, so it doesn't have as much cable for bandwidth transmission, or I don't know. Maybe it's just an old house that has shittier cables. Literally have no explanation. But it didn't work as well here. So I'm going with a pretty high quality TP-Link USB adapter for the time being. And it's doing all right. It just is inconsistent. It can run good speeds. It just, you know, kind of sinusoidally dodges in and out of it, which is not good for streaming because I need consistency. All right. I'm gonna let Nespresso stop using my stream to advertise. What is this? I didn't hit grocery breakfast. How did this happen? Here we go. Here's the exact brand, right? It's the Sweet Gourmet Albanese Sugar-Free Gummy Bears. And I'd like to read you some of the reviews right now because, boy howdy, they are funny. Of course, we gotta go to the one-star ones. Because if you haven't guessed at this point, these gummy bears, while being sugar-free, have a bit of a nuclear unintended side effect. All right, let's read one of these. This is entitled Saint Diarrhea's Day Massacre from February of last year. I purchased these gummy bears thinking, sounds like a nice purchase, 5 pounds of delicious candy for a decent price, can't go wrong. Unfortunately, I had to learn the hard way. It can go very wrong. First of all, I made the mistake of not reading the reviews before my purchase, and that was a mistake I will live with for the rest of my life due to the trauma I received after eating two handfuls of these. Two handfuls! That's like nothing. When you order a big bag of gummy bears, that's negligible amount. I was excited to try these for the first time, and I will say this, they were surprisingly tasty for being sugar-free, and I regretfully decided to try less than two handfuls within 5 minutes before I had to make a run to Walmart to purchase a few things that didn't include a stockpile of toilet paper. Within 15 minutes of consuming these high-power laxatives, my stomach was making noises that I should have seen as a message from God warning me, "You should turn back around and go home." I excused the funny feeling of my stomach as I was on a mission to replace a Keurig machine that broke from Walmart. Yeah, I said it, Walmart. As I parked my car, I felt my stomach growing more agitated by the minute, making gurgling noises that struck me as unusual, but I proceeded into the store as I really wanted a new coffee machine. God help me. I was literally in the middle of the store, looking at small kitchen appliances, before one loud gurgle after another, and then I squeezed out a fart that began as a long squeak, to jet propulsion in a split second that probably had some people in the store confuse the sound as a gunshot, and had them ducking for cover. As my situation had just gone from, on a 1 to 10 scale, from a 3 to an instant 12, literally soiling myself in the middle of a Walmart with hand towels and shower towels as my only source of fabric to wipe my ass with. I said, fuck the Keurig, and I ditched my cart and went running all the way to the opposite end of the store to the bathroom while what sounded and felt like I had firecrackers exploding in my underwear. People were probably pointing at me while their kids are laughing, and I finally made it to the bathroom to find one stall available. The handicap stall. Chapter 3. Upon entering the bathroom stall, while simultaneously crying and pulling down my pants. While simultaneously crying and pulling down my pants, I jumped on the toilet seat, not realizing it was literally covered in urine, and as I began opening the floodgates, releasing the evil that moments prior had begun rearranging my insides, I realized after the fact that there was no seat paper, and then I began holding on for dear life while begging a god to kill me, sounding off gunshots out of my ass that most likely had people running out of the store. Holy shit. Oh god, I hate public toilets. That shit makes me cringe. Use this product at your own risk and ask yourself, was it worth it? If the answer is yes, you should seek a mental health professional. This is a very widely upvoted review on a commercially available product on Amazon. You can't make this shit up. This one's just called Gastro Disastro. The amount of effort and wit that people put into writing these reviews give me such joy. Oh my god. Dean, yikes. Ooh. Phrasing, I guess. Yike. Winky face. Oh my god. 0 stars. Have been on the toilet for hours. I was looking for a no sugar gummy, not a whole system cleanse. I want to do negative stars. Oh my god. Oh my god. Not sugar free. Okay, this is not about the important part. Bowels beware. Being diabetic, it made sense to buy these sugar-free gummies. Come to find out, it didn't make sense that they would have me on the toilet for a couple days in a row, throwing the rest of the bag out as they should be reclassified as a heavy-duty laxative. Gummy laxatives. Like, 99% of these are just gummy laxatives. Subgoal for 100. Did I read that right? 100 gummy bears? I'll do it. I'll fucking do it. I might need it. I might need a full system cleanse. I've told you guys, I think on multiple occasions, the tale of the mega colon. How every year, on the year, during band camp, I cannot shit. It always occurs over the course of the week. Just cannot empty my bowels. I don't know. I don't understand how it possibly happens. I can't fathom how I can store that much food. But I just start inflating. Like that blueberry chick from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. And every year it happens. And every year, actually this year was not as bad. But last year, it lasted like an extra week after band camp. So I went 2 straight weeks minimum without shitting. That's like unhealthy, first of all, but also insane. Shout out to my bowels. How do you condense that much food? Because not only was it just 2 weeks worth of food, right? But I had been working out for like 12 hours a day. Band camp is a physical gauntlet. So you're consuming a lot of calories to make up for the energy you're expending. I was eating a ton of shit. I was eating like 2 Chipotle burritos every meal. Mega colon meets gummy bears. See, Danny? That's what I'm talking about. Maybe I need it. Maybe I've been stored up. Dean, it's not lack of fiber. Trust me, we did a lot of research. That's how we found out about megacolon in the first place. You think I didn't eat fiber, really? You think I'm so simple-minded that I didn't think to fucking shove fiber down my throat? I ate like 10 Clif Bars a day trying to up my fiber intake. I started eating just shredded wheat to up my fiber intake. I took laxatives my second year attempting it. That shit didn't even work. Laxatives did not work. Not only that, but I left the X-Lax out on the coffee table counter, and then we had friends over after band camp to celebrate it ending. And then not only did everybody see laxatives and attribute it to one of the 4 people living there, but fucking they knew it was me because everybody knew about my damn megacolon. I'm notorious for the megacolon. So long story short, 100 sub goal by the gummy bears? I like it. It works too, because I was thinking about buying the gummy bears as a fun stream gag. But they're $25 for gummy bears. It's not even like that many, is it? Okay, oh my god. Oh my god, it's 5 pounds? How many ounces are in a pound? Because this is 80 ounces. There's 12 ounces in a pound, right? So this is 60 ounces. Okay, that does make sense why it's less then. Fun stream gag, no one wants to watch you shit. Dean, you'd be surprised. You would be surprised. Wow, that stream delay is rough. That actually sucks. I don't know why it's like that. Should we reboot this puppy? Should we stab it with the defibrillator? Clear! I think it's worth a shot, right? What do you guys think? I mean, what are the downsides? They're just Frankenstein's monstering. It's much better? Okay. Can you give me a number? How much better? I've noticed it hasn't dipped again. So it hasn't done any of those kickbacks. At least not what I've noticed. But I've been pretty deep in the sugar-free gummy bear conversation. My curiosity, right, is what are the 5-star reviews for this? Like 7 seconds? Oh, people pog. Never mind. I'm not worried about it. That's not worth the stream restart. That is actually chef's kiss. Oh my god. Oh my god. Even the 5-star reviews are. People gave this product 5-star reviews and still wrote stories about it. Tasty, mostly non-problematic snack. This dude's got bowels of steel. Works as advertised. The gastrointestinal hell that these cause is truly biblical in proportion. Is that how they advertised it? Okay, digestive overload. Well, I bought these fully well knowing the consequences of my actions. However, the unforeseen events that followed include, but are not limited to, my prize-hunting dog unable to track due to the horrific stench of my bowels, my wife looking at me with cotton dipped in Vicks VapoRub shoved into each nostril, the bathroom toilet holding up a picket sign saying it wants an increase in wages if it's going to keep putting up with my digestive system, and a side petition from my neighborhood asking to please put a stop to suburban whale calling at all hours of the night. Oh my god, everything you read is true. He's writing it from the toilet. Only it decides when to go off. The gurgles, the rumbles, the odd sounds that emanate from your undercarriage are a wonder. Oh my god. I want to go deep into the reviews. Oh, delicious but at a cost. Oh my god. Drums in the deep. They are coming. Dude, I love how dramatic these are. This is from 5 years ago. Over 5 years ago. May 2015. And they have not fixed the shit-spewing properties of their gummy bears. I looked at the reviews online and thought it'd be fun to see if the stories are true. So the morning of my test for staff sergeant. Oh, how? Come on. You can't be that. I checked my mail and saw that they had arrived. In my excitement, I didn't think. I ate a few handfuls between tests to pass the time. You knew the consequences of your actions and you still sent it? Our best and brightest, ladies and gentlemen, the American military. I guess it could be another country, but statistically, probably the US military. They're very sweet and taste great, but don't let the cute bears fool you. They are after your pooper's soul. Halfway through my second test, I felt a rumble. I looked to see if people were running from an earthquake, but it wasn't so. Surely that couldn't have been me. Another, and another, and then a squeaker. Oh no, what had I done? To leave the room for any reason would be to forfeit the test. A hot sweat came creeping on the back of my neck, reaching to my forehead. I began to think this pain was worth my future. I began to think, was this pain worth my future? And then a thought, was my future worth this pain? In between not so silent attempts to relieve the stress, my stomach rumbled and glugged like a flooded engine. I can do this, I told myself. I must do this. 10 questions to go, I summoned all my knowledge and prayed to any god that would listen to deliver me from this curse. As I went, I could feel the glare of those unfortunate around me. It didn't matter if I didn't hurry. They would have a lot more to see. 3, 2, 1. Finished. As I ran to the front of the room, half covered in sweat, I waited for her to say I was clear before jolting to the bathroom. As I pulled down my pants, it began. With a sizzle and shots of fury, it felt like I had put a Roman candle in a sparkler. That's our second fireworks analogy in two reviews. Oh, God. You really want me to eat 100 of these? Oh, no. As I ran to the front of the room, half covered in sweat, I waited for her to say I was clear before jolting to the bathroom. As I pulled down my pants, it began. With a sizzle and shots of fury, it felt like I had put a Roman candle and a sparkler inside of me. I wondered if this was purgatory or the inferno. The minutes dragged on for what seemed like forever. Finally, all was still. I made it. It was finally over. Or was it? 10 out of 10. Ruined life for me. Would recommend. Dude, I... These are all written like fables. It's so easy to forget that these are product reviews. Very good. Great taste. I'm a diabetic and I'm used to the alcohol sugars. Just do not overconsume. Didn't this person eat like 10? A few handfuls. Okay. Oh my god. I read the very colorful reviews but still skeptical. Reviews either seemed over the top, dramatic, or unbelievable. I do kind of agree it's a little over the top, but there's a part of me that wants to believe. Test subject tarted with a small handful of gummy bears at 8:45 p.m. About 10 pieces. I like this. This is a scientific study. Our hypothesis. Sugar-free gummy bears make you shit like Mount Vesuvius. Experimental procedure. The test subject noted that the texture is a little more chewy than fresh, standard gummy bears, but can be easily explained to anyone as being a little stale. The taste was on par, a little less sweet than standard, but very acceptable. Not a noticeable difference. About 30 minutes later, the test subject displayed no signs of discomfort. With the precision of a field medic attending a dying man on the field, I upped the dosage. Oh, God. I mean, the test subject then had a full bowl, about two decent-sized handfuls, or about the size of a small prize or present cellophane bag, as if you were to get a special treat bag at work. Very scientific measuring. Okay, approximately a shit ton. Still nothing. I was about to write a negative review on Amazon. Oh man, I was upset. The test subject noted feeling a discomfort like cramping on the upper gastrointestinal tract. It wasn't gurgling yet, it was just a hard-like discomfort. This feeling started about 1 hour after the larger dose. About 1.5 hours after initial intake, the first urge to release was intense and did not allow any time for delay. Do not laugh when it happens. You will not hold back. For the next 3 hours, the test subject sat down to pee from the anus. The anus. I am pee from my anus. You are telling me the man who tried to put rubber fists in my anus was a homosexual? Not nice. Oh my god. If you couldn't tell, I just watched Borat this past weekend, and that is a cinematic masterpiece. Alright, let's read the conclusion of this shit, and then I'm done. It is not extreme pain or smell like what is experienced with sickness or food poisoning. It is more like a purge. Don't try to fight it. Based on the experience of the test subject, I deduce that these gummy bears will not allow for productivity. This is not painful, and it is not residual, so once it leaves your system, you're done. The test subject went back to normal without issues. That's relieving to hear. So to reiterate, not painful, but not something you can hold in. Short duration overall. Short duration, it was 3 hours. But perfect lag time from intake to explosion. This is an ideal colon cleansing agent. I think the test subject lost 5 pounds of water weight in the process. I'm not sure though, I didn't weigh myself. It's not like I'm a freaking scientist. Oh wow, the twist was that he was the test subject all along. That was beautifully written. Oh my god. Wow. Whew. So anyway, my anus is destroyed. So anyway, I tripled my diameter. How's everybody else doing? Wow. Oh my god. All right, new sub goal. Let me write it down. Gozo wanted me to get... what was it? What did Gozo want me to get? It was a Peepo emote. No, it was cat dance, I think. Yeah, Gozo wanted me to get cat dance. What was we gonna run down? Laxative. Bears. Sub. goal. Alright, for next stream. That's a lofty goal, but it's also a hefty punishment if we reach it. So I think it's commensurate. I think you put in what you get out, and it is a fair exchange. My anus for 100 subs. Okay, without context, that sounds a little bad, but with context, it's even worse. It's way worse. Alright, let me start opening Steam. Because my plan for the rest of the night, Fall Guys, baby. I've been dog shit at Fall Guys. I only got 2 dubs, and I got them after grinding for a while. So it's time to become one of the best. It's time to join the upper echelons of Fall Guys society. I'm aiming for 5 dubs, boys. So anyway, my anus is destroyed. Dude, I don't know why I find it so funny, but it's just so good. They're so inconspicuous. They're just little bears. They're just little colorful, sugary bears. Until it's too late. Once you hit 10, it's over for your digestive tract. Oh man. Anyway, vibe check. How you boys doing? How's everybody's day been? I've ranted a lot about myself and about other random stranger shitters on the internet. Jelly Dean. Gabe, how you guys doing? Whew. Oh my god. Steam, stop updating. We have bigger priorities right now. Much larger priorities. Wow, I haven't booted up Steam in a long time. I haven't booted up Steam since last stream. It's got a shit ton of updates to do. Which is also a depressing reflection of... It's been 5 days since my last stream. Whoops. Whoopsie. Cringe. Next YouTube video is almost done, though. I just have to make a thumbnail. Oh, shit. Maybe if we either do really well at Fall Guys and get a shit ton of dubs, or I just do dog shit and start malding and immediately rage quit the game. Other stream priorities, right? Gotta make a thumbnail for the new YouTube vid, and gotta make new emotes. With the chair sub goal, we unlock 2 more emote slots. So I'm thinking, I don't know, it seems greedy, right? But I'm thinking of using 2 of the emotes, the 2 slots that we have now, for a double word emote. That would be wah wah wee wah. So one of them would be wah and the other would be wee. So then you could just do whatever fucking permutation of those 2 syllables you want, and we'll just get a ton of wee wee spam in chat, but we'll slip it past Twitch's profanity filter, because I'll be like, it's so we can say wah wah wee wah. My only concern is, before we hit Twitch partner, I only get 5 emote slots. So to use 40% of them on a stupid wah-wah-wee-wah-wee-wee joke is brazen, to say the least. Oh, but it's so funny. I think it just might be worth it. Oh, man. Whew. Holy shit. Oh, I need to open the vent. That's what I need to do. We're running the AC and I don't even have the vent open. Damn, I'm stupid. One moment. Whatever, Dean. Nobody asks you. Put in what you get out. Yeah, whatever. It works the same way. Just flip-flop it. You do put in... If you get out what you put in, you also put in what you get out. It's just not chronological. I'm sorry my syntax isn't good enough for you, Dean. Will you ever take me back? Oh, here's another scuffed thing. Let me show you guys something about my controller. We're going to be playing Fall Guys on hard... Oh, no. It got worse. It got way worse. All right, so my controller, right? Either the cable itself is fucked, or the hole where it connects is fucked. One of the two. But if I have the cable just sitting normally, it doesn't work. It starts blinking because I got batteries in it, but it's no longer receiving signal or power from the cable. I have to push it down. I have to pull it back this way. It should be solid now. There. I have to do that always while I'm playing the game, or the controller will completely disconnect, and that is without fail. So we're playing Fall Guys on hard mode, where I am now down a finger. Welcome to, oh my god, why is the green screen so scuffed? How did this happen? How am I queuing? How am I queuing? Who did this? OMG, LMAO, crying, laughing emoji. Who did this? Damn, my whole setup's fucked. You know why? It's because I rotated one of my monitors to play Wind Waker from my bed because I got a Dolphin GameCube emulator. Oh, shit slaps. Wind Waker's such a good game. But it throws off my entire stream setup when I rotate my monitor around. All right, Fall Guys, Fall Guys, Fall Guys. Why is it not being captured? There we go. But I'm kind of sick of the Fall Guys music. What? What is this? Green screen leakage? Unacceptable. Let me update the stream category. Falling Man. We'll put how many dubs we have in the title. 'Cause I'm proud of it. All right. Just in time. Oh shit, I forgot that I have to press the controller down. Okay. Oh man, I was just talking about it and I've already forgotten. All right, now I've been practicing. I don't know if you can tell, but I got the Fall Guy drip now. My character is one shmexy looking jelly bean boy. And it shows. Is depth of field on? Oh, that's gross. I'm gonna have to turn that off. We're gonna have to fiddle with some settings here. Get out of my way! Oh no, am I really gonna lose on Dizzy Heights? This one's so easy. Is that a hot dog? More like Glizzy Heights. There's another wood guy. No! He almost fucked me. Almost. All right, now this game may look lighthearted and colorful, but I'm out here to win. I'm out here to slice the throats of the competition and leave them in my dust. I'm getting this crown. Boom! All right, let's tinker with some settings while we're here. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Are we ever gonna have the chance to mess with the settings? Uh-oh. I guess we're just stuck in Fall Guys Purgatory for now. Right, easy first round. Dude, it's like a sauna in my room now. I thought as we got into September, usually it's like snowing by this time of year in Indiana. So I thought it'd be a little chilly, but no, instead we're getting lightning storms like every day. I think 50% of my band rehearsals have been cut in half because there's been lightning within a 5 mile radius and we have to disperse for like legal reasons. The school's gotta have their bases covered. It's insane. I've never had this many lightning storms happen. And I love them, but I wish they could just happen on the weekend. But then they did happen on the weekend on Sunday, and I lost power and couldn't stream. So, it's a lose-lose. No. Okay, never mind. The gambit's not worth it. The gambit is not worth it. This one is. There we go. Oh, no. I'm not gonna lose on Slime Climb. I'm not gonna lose on Slime Climb. This one's like my favorite. I refuse to lose on Slime Climb. Straight up. Okay, that did not work. Nope. Stop going for stupid shit. Just play it how it's meant to be played. No, get out of my way. There we go. Yes. Okay. Whew. I did the risky leaps, but it worked in my favor. I really thought I was gonna get pushed off. It's not even the obstacles on this course that make it challenging, it's just the crowd. But I'm out here to win. Ninja, get out of my. Fuck those guys. My fellow wood boy. I found him. Okay, never mind. I'm not gonna try the shortcut. Today was like the first day we actually got cut short. No, this was like the fourth. There was like a Tuesday last week and then Tuesday the week before. And then yesterday there were like concerns of not having rehearsal, but we did have it. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Well, I'm just starting to feel the wine. Oh! It's gonna supercharge me, turn me into the ultimate fall guy. I am the fall man. But first, shopping spree! What's popping in the store? I can't believe we didn't check first. Oh no, dude, everybody's gonna be wearing this. The banana from my friend Pedro. Oh, I'm actually okay with it. I'm pumped to see a shit ton of bananas running around. What do we got in here? Wave gradient? Oh god, that looks so gross. Constellations, that looks sick. That's a dope skin. Wait, do I have three dubs now? Wait. What's the math? What's the math on this? Because I thought that the color I'm wearing cost one crown. But I also have. No, I only have two dubs. I think I've gotten two crowns from leveling up as a whole. I think. Shit. I don't actually know. That is a disgusting skin. Pineapple, kind of cute. Gradient? Not a fan. Not a fan. At least not with these colors. That a color scheme? All right. Nothing too crazy. I love the banana. I can't wait to see other people wearing it, but I ain't gonna touch it. I ain't gonna touch it with a 10-foot pole. The other Tuesday just got rescheduled. Yeah, that's a good point. I guess they didn't all get cut short, but we've had a lot of rehearsals interfered with by lightning. I think we can all agree on that. We definitely had a Tuesday recently where they scrubbed it while we were there, and we just had to go straight into Shreve from the field. Oh man. How's your day been, Danny? Been working on those cadences? Sorry, I didn't mean to target the conversation. I'm gonna be reviewing mine after the stream. That's for sure. On the statistically unlikely chance that any other bases are watching, click off. Start memorizing, boys and girl. Get your shit done. Oh man, now I'm really feeling the wine. Let's just finish it off, shall we? Woo! All right. At least something I can close. Something I can finish the job. Whew, that was not even proper English. Sorry, I'm not focused on my sentences. Damn it, I forgot to turn off depth of field again. It's scuffed. It's scuffed. I'm actually dying in my room. I just took a shower because I was sweating like a pig earlier today. Oh, I should not have tried to be brave. Oh, that was so stupid. I might lose because I was picking a new route instead of just following the crowd. Come on, come on, come on. Just become part of the flow. Just become part of the flow. Wait. It's gonna be close. Fuck! Oh my god, I'm so bad at this game. Imagine losing on round one of Fall Guys. Holy shit. Fair enough. No, don't worry about it. Assassin's Creed 4? Hell yeah, dude. That's Black Flag, right? Assassin's Creed 4 is so good. Oh, I might have to finish the Assassin's Creed Odyssey DLC sometime. That game, if you haven't, excuse me, if you haven't played it already, Odyssey is so phenomenal. It's such a, oh my god, excuse me, that's the wine talking. It is such a fantastic game. Motion blur? Hell no. Depth of field? Absolutely not. We'll keep anti-aliasing high. We'll do SAO. And turn it to high. Oh, wait. Yeah, I don't know what that is. All right. I'm satisfied. Audio? Let's get our own music, shall we? There we go. Might have to turn Spotify down just a tick. Just a little bit. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, I'm already. I gotta admit, I was losing a little bit of steam because it's evaporating off of me because this room is so goddamn unbearably hot. But now that I got my jams, now we win these. So I do have some interesting news. It's gonna be an F for the Twitter! Exclamation point Twitter! It's shut down. It's over, boys. My dad has officially followed me on Twitter. I can't tweet anymore. I at least can't tweet my usual shit. I think one of my most recent tweets was, "Damn, just failed no poop August," or something like that. I can't tweet like that knowing my dad is watching. I mean, I still will. You should still drop a follow, but damn, it's just different. It just hits different when your dad's following your Twitter. Now I feel like I have to be prim and proper and tweet about, I just applied for job applications. Boy, I sure do have a resume. Oh my god, this game is infinitely better without depth of field. I do not know why that setting exists. Oh my god, it looks so great now. It's like putting your glasses on after rubbing your eyes with chlorine. Right, here we go, here we go. Don't go against the flow. Be the flow, be the flow. How did that dude squeeze through? That was insane. His body is so squishy and malleable. Whoa, that was risky. No, 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 no. I'm not gonna get eliminated on the easiest part of the easiest map. Nah, easy qualify right here. Boom, boys. Watch me. Top 20. Top 20? Nope. Top 30. Top 30. We take that. I'm in the 75th percentile, baby. Wait, no. I'm in the 25th percentile, baby. I'll take that. 25th percentile means I still got a shot at winning. Is that a banana and an egg? Oh my god. I can't wait till they just add more and more skins. I love seeing the weird ass amalgamation top and bottom half mashups that people make. So good. Damn, you got me craving Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Oh, it's such a good game. The story, okay, the story in the first DLC takes a really weird turn. It was a controversial turn to some people. And I wasn't a huge fan of it either. But I don't want to spoil it because it's still a phenomenal game. And it's still an interesting story. Like, if you can get over the weird decisions they make and get invested in the characters that are admittedly you have to force yourself to like the characters. But if you can do that, I think it's a genuinely gripping, compelling tale. That being said, the main story does not have that problem. Main story is great. It's fantastic. It gets you attached to characters who are also named after and loosely based on historical figures. I mean, it's Assassin's Creed, so how historically accurate is it gonna be? But I just love the setting of ancient Greece. I love the historical figures that come along with it. The graphics of that game are gorgeous when combined with the aesthetic. It's just a great game, man. I could gush about it. No, what? It was going so well. It was going so well until it wasn't. Damn, how does that even happen? You stupid little USB, do your damn job. You Fall Guys netcode, do your damn job. That's rough. Oh, you hate to see it. I wonder what happened to Salmon. He had to take a casserole out of his oven and now he's gone forever. May he rest in peace. He didn't take it out of the oven in time and his house burned down. Damn, Salmon. Oh, Mario Galaxy. I lost Craigasm. Alright, Seesaw. This is my jam. As long as you can get ahead of the pack on Seesaw, you are the king in the castle. King in the castle. I have chair, look at me. Okay, well I already started in the back, I already started at the disadvantage. And I'm gonna fall here. Yep, come on, push. No, push. Please, do it for me, you little jelly bean bitch. Hell yes. Alright, we're not in the lead, but we're also not in the back of the pack. Which is good, because people be stupid. Including myself, I'm kind of getting caught up in the herd mentality. I'll confess. There we go. You see that flip? Oh, I'm styling on him. It was going so well. How does this happen? He dropped the casserole. Oh my god, my internet dropped the game. I think we try one more and we might just have to fucking call it on the Fall Guys. My controller's disconnecting and reconnecting. My internet's disconnecting and reconnecting. My bitrate is disconnecting and reconnecting. It's scuffed, man. I think it might just be might not be meant to be. Wow. That sentence was hard for me to push out of my little gullet. Yikes. Ooh, but one of my cups fits nicely into my other cup. Wow, they get destroyed by the green screen. That is just awful to see. Alright, we're giving it one more shot. Third time's the charm. I shouldn't have drank, boys. What is it, a Tuesday night? What was I thinking? Actually, what was I thinking? Y'all are a bad influence on me. Alright, with Super Mario Galaxy soundtrack at my back. And the wind at my four. You can deliver a working... Can you bring me a fucking working internet while you're at it? I'm mauled. I didn't want to be connected to the server. I don't even like the server. You know what? I'll make my own server with blackjack and hookers. Oh, that's so tragic. Every time it just lasted shorter and shorter. Well, that's that plan thrown out the window. Should we work on the emotes? I'm not ready to work on the emotes because I haven't decided if that's what I want to roll with or not. I feel like it's too brazen to spend two of my four emote slots on a stupid verbal letter joke. Oh, I shouldn't have gotten tipsy. Oh, it's one of those nights. Ooh. Damn. It actually is one of those nights. I think... Man, I hate to say it. This might be the earliest I've ever called a stream, but I think I'm just going to work on YouTube content and improving the stream for next time, because it's getting hot in here. I need to turn the fan on. My allergies are starting to kill me. It's just one of those days. Also, I got a little too tipsy. I'm at that spot where it's not good. Yeah, man. This might be... I'm a little ashamed with how short this stream was, but I really enjoyed how it went. As brief as it was... Yeah, I think I gotta close. That's unfortunate, but it seems like the best way to go from here. Even if my mind is... But I can't trust myself. I'm drunk. I can't listen to myself. Yeah, Danny, if you just got to the part where it's where my internet is not working, then the stream lag is insane. I need to figure that out too. Ooh, it's so scuffed, m'lady. M'lady, it needs some work, and I think it would be a more productive use of my time stream-wise to dedicate it off-stream to making next stream better rather than just piddling around. So yeah, no more stalling. It's too hot in my room. I'm sweating like a fucking pig. I'm in a sauna. I'm in the oven. This was a blast, fellas. Thank you for coming out. Let's find somebody to raid. It'll be a little bit of a flaccid, steamy, allergy-infested raid. But it's a raid nonetheless. No reason to wrap up without transferring people. I feel like I'm cucking you guys of entertainment by wrapping up stream so soon. That's not fair to you. So let's raid our boy Marsh. Why not? For the boys. He be streaming. Full desktop. He's streaming Among Us. I love Among Us. That is such a fucking good game. If I wasn't gonna work on thumbnails and emotes, I would be watching the shit out of this. So say hi to the boy. For your boy, drop a couple Turkey 17s in chat, ask him some questions or something. He's just a fellow variety streamer like myself, and he was a fellow contestant on the Ludwig Ogren talent show months and months ago, so that's how we met. Absolute legend, total goat. Check him out, say hi for me. Let's raid him, let's do it. You guys have a good night, thanks for coming out. I'm sorry this was so scuffed. I'm sorry, it really fell apart at the end. My bitrate is now zero. I think it's crashed. Oh no, it's officially gone down the shitter.